What is it that's unique about either your model or just the tool, the generative AI tool?
Yeah, so thank you for having me here. So Perplexity is an AI-powered conversational answer engine. It's not a search engine. So you ask a query, you ask a question, it just directly gives you the answer. The main difference from other chatbots like ChatGPT is that you always get the sources. So it only says what exists on the web already, and it clearly tells the user where every part of the answer, where is it coming from on the web.
One of the backers or investors is NVIDIA, but are they also supporting you in compute? Did you get access to an H100 cluster, for example?
So NVIDIA is an investor in us strategically, where we partner with them to work on frameworks for training and inference, but we have all our compute cluster on other hyperscalers like AWS.
Competition. I get that the uniqueness is that the source is clearly labeled, but you're directly taking on ChatGPT, Bard. Mm-hmm. Is the sourcing enough to sort of differentiate in that market?
Yeah, so our perspective is that AI chatbots are going to be of wide variety. There's going to be a chatbot for you to go and brainstorm new ideas and interact with it to like ask for ideas for birthday presents or generate essays or write poems. There's going to be character AI like chatbots where you're chatting with personalities. But there has to be one single chatbot which you rely on for accurate, live, correct information on the web. And that market is there for the taking, and we want to go for that.
And 10 million people on a monthly basis do. I'm interested in your desire to go out and build this, Aravind, because you were at OpenAI as a researcher. You've been working with DeepMind. Why did you feel that something new was necessary to be created?
I always wanted to try an entrepreneurial journey. So it was not meant to go and create a company for search. We initially started off as just to brainstorm and create products using the large language models as an upcoming technology. Much before it was even called generative AI, it was just that we stumbled on this amazing idea of combining large language models and web search together in the form of a new product called Perplexity.
So you raise this money. Is that to be put towards R&D, compute power? Is it a little bit of marketing? Because I'm kind of interested as how you got into the hands of 10 million people.
Yeah, so we've really been fortunate to have completely organic growth. We haven't paid for any of these users. We obviously announce all our product features on Twitter, and like people follow us there and like get to know about us, and there's a lot of word of mouth growth for us. But our spend is largely going to be on scaling adoption and usage, and that's going to be spent more on compute resources, as you point out.
Caroline and I have experienced some of that word of mouth about Perplexity. Here's the thing. The story with OpenAI was about the push to commercialize. Do you feel, as a founder and leader of that company, that pressure?
Well, honestly, I think people just want progress, and progress can be reflected in terms of clear user growth and adoption and not just through revenue. So as you get more and more users, there's always going to be plenty of opportunities for you to monetize, either through subscriptions or other forms of monetization. And therefore, right now, all our investors are pretty aligned with this, that we actually want to scale more in terms of growing a larger user base.